If you are thinking of running with the bulls, you have to prepare well. Obviously, you have to do your research before the fiesta. You need to watch videos of the run and read any advice that has been posted on the internet, but make sure you disregard some of the rubbish. Unfortunately, you often get idiotic comments posted by runners that have only experienced the bull run once or twice. You have to ignore them. When you get to Pamplona, you must make sure you watch from a balcony the day before you're going to run, preferably in Estafeta, which is a good place for first-time runners. And make sure it is in a high-level balcony so you can see the bulls approaching and after they have passed your position. It gives you a better idea of the different parts of Estafeta and what happens in the bull run. Make sure you walk the course the day before to give you an idea of the overall distances involved. If you are lucky enough to strike up a conversation with an experienced runner at Bar Windsor or Bar Choco, then suggest in exchange for a nice meal that they could walk you through the course explaining what happens. Make sure you know where all the escape points are in the section that you're going to run, and practice getting over and under the wooden barricades at the side of the course in case you have to exit because of a suelto. A suelto is a bull that has become separated from the herd. Many people have not done this before they run and often pay the penalty for this lack of practice. Sueltos will hit out at anything that moves, so you should always try to get out of harm's way as long as you can do so without attracting its attention. If a suelto is too close, then just squeeze against the wall and freeze like a statue. Hopefully, the suelto will just ignore you and move on. But do not try to climb over the barricades just because you have changed your mind about running. The police will not let you do that. But one of the most important bits of preparation is to get a good night's sleep. Staying up all night and drinking all night is a very bad idea.
And the only American to die in the Encierro was a boy named Matthew Tassio,
yeah, who
came here. Basically one night went out and got drunk and had a great time, was up most of the night and said, I'm gonna run with the bulls. Didn't know anything about it, and he fell down and he didn't know to stay down. And he lifted himself up and there was a bull right behind him at a full gallop and just whacked him with a horn.
And kept going, the bull just kept going, yeah. He was dead. The
bull wanted to push him out of the way.
Into him basically, yeah. Almost, you know, taking out his abdomen.
A fatal mistake. And today I'm on the course and I hear somebody there talking and I'm trying to, you know, you try to help people, but I'm also very nervous. And the kid says,
well, I think the bulls come from that way, but if they come from this way, we're right in the middle, so it's okay.
Somebody asked me that today this morning also, which way do they
go? I can't believe that people actually ask.
If you cannot find hotel accommodation, there is an alternative, cheaper option.